Hello, beautiful people. Today we're going to play and review Fire Shark for the Sega Mega Drive. Let's do this. Welcome, everybody. Thank you for tuning into my channel. If you are tuning for the very first time, it's a pleasure as always to have you with us. And without further ado, let's get on with the show. Okay, so Fire Shark was released back in 1989 for the Sega Mega Drive. And I'll be honest with you, it's not a well-known shoot 'em up. For those hardcore gamers out there, you'll know it well. I do remember the first time I played this one as a kid. Stepbrother tired it out from the local video store. Never heard of it. And I expected it to be a load of rubbish. Visually, fantastic graphics. Killer soundtrack. But it is a difficult game. So it's one hit, you're dead. So it does take a bit of skill. You get some really cool power-ups as well when you're playing this game. I'm actually going to demonstrate that now and show you a cheat. Pause the game. Press up A, down B, left C, right and start. And here's where you can change power ups. Max out the bombs. Watch this. Come on, baby. Look at that. Just make the game so much easier. Definitely my favourite weapon of choice. You usually gotta get through a few levels just to get this. This cheat does come in handy. Thank me later for that. Yeah, if you are on social media, you can follow me on Instagram. Check out the Manc Retro Gamer. I do post regular retro gaming content on there, and also alerts when I'll be uploading new reviews to my channel. But yeah, check out my page if you get a chance. Fantastic retro gaming community on there, and they'll all make you feel welcome. You can get involved in the comments. So yeah, it's first level done. Yeah guys, so let me know in the comments below what you think of this so far. So it's a rare gem of a game. I do remember I was collecting the Mega Drive games a while ago, and this one was quite rare. It cost me quite a bit of money as well to say. It was well worth it. Don't want that blue thing. I think the only bugbear with this is like many shooter mobs where they can quickly become repetitive. Yeah, it does take some skill list to master. definitely think they nailed it with the soundtrack. I could have reviewed this without using this cheat, but I had too much fun by playing it this way, to be honest. Yeah, definitely ought to be switching him weapon over so we can avoid them. Fast now. It's definitely the ultimate weapon for me, this. Right guys, so I'm gonna wrap up this review and let you know my final thoughts and what I think of Fire Shark. So overall I have enjoyed playing this, and I do think visually graphics really decent for shooting up. Fantastic soundtrack. I think the only thing that lets it down, it does become competitive pretty quickly. Yeah, it's a decent shoot up. As I say, it's not well known out there. If you're after playing a shoot 'em up you've never played before, or you haven't, you just want to play this again, I would recommend it. It's decent. So yeah, I'm going to give this a 7 out of 10, because it does say very repetitive. It does progressively get harder. And it is one of the games, so once you've played it though, you do kind of lose interest, and it's one that you'll probably put away after a while. So yeah, 7 out of 10. Hey guys, so if you have enjoyed this, please smash that like button, stick a comment below any games you'd like me to review for in the future, and hit that subscribe button, really mean a lot to me. And as always, I've been the Manc Retro Gamer. Take care of yourselves and each other. Bye bye.